see, it just started the fifth train. And it's on the viaduct. It was heavy. Russell could barely felt. It raced down when they were on the viaduct and slowed down when they went into the tunnel. Nope. Almost 5 seconds after he had entered. He was so fast, he arrived early. He got coupled and raced away back to the center table. Bull Chester's his wheels running. As he had just returned, Treasure switched spots. Skylarry into that spot. And Smudger took Skylarry's spot. It was dark.
Really
hope you got the hit, but for the entire sneaky team as well. They're gonna say, work tirelessly in that team. Bring your backup to stand in front of the resource in case of the Yamaha and the Holland. Thank you for your boost. It was almost midnight. Well, not really. It was only 9 o'clock. And no more trains. No more trains were going on that until summer. Until the summer now. And it was the beginning. Only the middle of the spring. And all the engines had fallen asleep. At midnight they woke up. They thought they heard an unfamiliar. Well, they thought at first it was like the engines that were coming. But then they realized it was only Caroline and Butch's horns. And they were just trying to wake them up. Now everyone was staring at them. Caroline, said Butch. What? Neither of us, it just happened. And no. Just then. A fence went past them into the tunnel. What was that? Shaking. The car was stuck in the tunnel. Blaine went into the tunnel. Then Blaine got stuck and there to the hill. There was just a little guy part, and they put it out of the way. They were talking. The new engines had arrested the other railway for a month. It was the scariest place they've ever seen. They weren't there yet. But they were almost. They were about to go onto the island of Sodor.